The Prime Minister is tonight preparing to meet with Ukraine's president, who was earlier greeted by thousands of supporters in Eastern Europe. Volodymyr Zelensky sending a frustrated message to NATO leaders. Give the country a path to membership or allow Russia to continue its terror.
At a rally in Lithuania's capital, Zelensky, the Ukrainian president emerging like a boxer on his way to the ring, but this the fight of his and his country's life.
Thanks, Lithuania. Thank you very much.
More than 500 days after Russia's invasion, Volodymyr Zelensky meeting with NATO leaders, requesting more assistance and, crucially, a fast track to membership of the world's most powerful alliance. The president had tweeted his complaints. It's unprecedented and absurd when time frame is not set, neither for the invitation nor Ukraine's membership, noting uncertainty is weakness.
The most urgent task now is to ensure that Ukraine prevails, because unless Ukraine prevails, there is no membership issue to be discussed at all.
What we hear and understand that we'll have this invitation when security measures will allow.
Australia doesn't get a vote, but our Prime Minister does get a seat at the table. A string of sit-downs for Anthony Albanese, including with UK Prime Minister Rishi Sunak, friend in diplomacy, but foe on the cricket pitch.
I'm sorry I didn't bring my sandpaper with me.
There's a crease.
Indo-Pacific allies also pledging their support for the war effort.
Australia has a great history of standing up for what is right, whether that was World War One, World War Two, or whether it be right now.
It's not just the NATO leaders showing their support. Thousands of Lithuanian people, just generations from their own Soviet rule, turning out to support the Ukrainian leader.
We really, really feel for our brothers in Ukraine.
President Zelensky and Prime Minister Albanese will meet again tonight on the sidelines of this summit near the front lines of a war. In Vilnius, Lithuania, Charles Croucher, Nine News.
Defence is clearly the focus here, but tonight Australia has been attempting to negotiate without success that free trade agreement with the European Union. It culminated with Anthony Albanese meeting with the head of the European Commission. The sticking point remains agriculture, and in particular the rights for our producers to use European names for their products, things like Prosecco and Feta. The government initially wanted this free trade agreement finalised by July. The new deadline is Christmas, but our negotiators say they are willing to walk away. New Zealand finalised their free trade agreement last week. Our side is clearly playing harder to get, but as the clock ticks, that gets harder to play.
Good on you, Charles. Thank you.